So you've got a new Surface Pen. Let's set it up. The first thing you're going to want to do is pair the pen to your new Surface device. So once you're logged in, you're going to hit Start and then open up Settings. Once you're in Settings, the pen is of course a new device, so we're going to go into the Devices area. The very first place we see is Bluetooth and other devices, and that's perfect because that is how your Surface Pen connects to your computer. So we're going to press Add Bluetooth or Other Device. Now, because the Surface Pen is a Bluetooth device, we're going to hit this button. But before we do, we want to make sure our Surface Pen is in pairing mode. To put the Surface Pen in pairing mode, we're going to press the top of the button for just a few seconds until we see this nice little light appear on the top of the pen. This lets you know that it is able to be found. So I'm going to select Bluetooth in Windows 10. And you'll see my first option is that Surface Pen. It's important you do this not with your colleagues, but alone, so that you can tell the difference between your pen and others. Now you'll notice the light has stopped flashing, and my Surface Pen is now paired. Now, the pen will still work without being paired, but you pair it in order to customize what happens when you click the top of your pen. So once you pair your pen, you'll notice a new area has appeared called Pen and Windows Ink. I'm going to press here. This allows you to customize which hand you write with, so it will show menus in the correct place. And as you scroll down, you'll even see pen shortcuts. Now, this can be configured to whatever you'd like. By default, I can click it once, and that will bring me Windows Ink Workspace, which shows me some nice new features that we've added to Windows specifically for the pen. Things like sticky notes, sketchpad, or taking a screen capture and writing on it. Now, you can have that be your default, or if you're a fan of OneNote or any other application, you can choose them and customize them here from this list. For example, by default, when I do two clicks of my pen, I have that set to do Snip and Sketch and give me the ability to annotate right on top of my display. I won't save my changes to this. When you press and hold by default, the pen will summon Her Royal Highness Cortana, and that's just fine. I'll go ahead and excuse her for now, but you could, of course, customize this to do whatever you'd like. This last checkbox, though, is important. Allow apps to override this button behavior. This is important for apps like PowerPoint. Whenever you have a PowerPoint presentation running, you can use your Surface Pen now with one click to advance to the next slide and press and hold to go backwards. It's really quite amazing, and that button must be checked in order for that to work. Just like that, you have set up and configured your Surface Pen, and it's ready for all you plan to do.